Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So this series is about our daily current affair MCQs. So as is clear from its name, this series is we daily discuss 10 MCQs from your current affairs point of view. So today is 31st August. Let's see what are the questions of today. So the first question is, consider the following statements related to measles disease. First, measles is a bacterial infectious disease. Second, it is preventable through vaccine. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So friends, there is no point of saying that I think the answer is B, because obviously as is shown on your screen, the answer is B. That is second only, it is preventable through vaccine. So measles is an acute and highly infectious disease of children. Basically, it is transmitted through droplets from nose, mouth or throat. So it is caused by viruses and not bacteria. So please note that it is basically a viral disease, and it is characterized by fever and upper respiratory tract symptoms like cough and cold, coryza. So the rash of measles is typical. So you might have seen the children who have red spots on their skin. Mostly these red spots appear on mouth and the throat. So a common symptom and diagnostic point is tiny grayish white spots called complex spots in the mouth and the throat. So it is an infection of the respiratory system caused by a virus, specifically a paramyxovirus, which is single-stranded negative sense enveloped RNA virus of the genus Morbillivirus virus within the family of Paramyxoviridae. So you don't have to go in that detail. So they are the natural hosts of virus, that is humans. So measles can be prevented through a vaccine called MMR, measles, mumps and rubella. So this is basically a vaccine which prevents three diseases. Please note it: measles, mumps and rubella. So routine immunization is highly effective in prevention of measles. And your next question is, consider the following statements related to Northeast Rural Livelihood Project. First, it is implemented by Ministry of Rural Development. Second, it is aided by the World Bank. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that the answer is B. That is it is aided by World Bank. It is not implemented by Ministry of Rural Development, but rather there is a special ministry which focuses upon northeastern region, and that is Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region. This multi-state livelihood project was launched by this ministry, that is Northeast Rural Livelihood Project. So aim is to improve rural livelihood opportunities, especially that of women unemployed youth and the most disadvantaged in the four northeastern states. So the project has focused on five developmental strategies, that is social empowerment, economic empowerment, partnership development, project management, livelihood and value chain. And next question is, PESA portal is in news is related to A, centralized IT platform to release interest subvention; B, platform to buy Bitcoin coins; C, to buy RBI's coins; D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is A, that is centralized IT platform to release interest subvention. So National Urban Livelihood Mission conferred the prestigious Scotch Governance Gold Award. So it has been conferred this Scotch Governance Gold Award. So the award has been conferred for its portal for affordable credit and interest subvention access. So basically, PESA portal is a centralized IT platform which simplifies and streamlines the release of interest subvention under the mission. So it offers end-to-end online solution for processing, payment, monitoring and tracking of interest subvention claims from bank on a monthly basis. So it is designed and developed by Allahabad Bank. So about this, please note that this PESA portal is developed by Allahabad Bank. So it is a nodal bank. So Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana. So basically it has been the renamed version of National Urban Livelihood Mission. So in Hindi it is Rashtriya Shahri Ajivika Mission. So it has been renamed now. So basically under the scheme, it covers the urban areas to all the 4041 statutory cities and towns, thereby covering almost the entire urban population. So as is clear from its name, so this is basically to provide to reduce poverty and vulnerability of urban poor by enabling them to access gainful self-employment. So you can, if you want to relate it, if you want to draw analogy, then you can draw analogy with MG Narega. But that analogy will not be correct, because in MG Narega there is a kind of a legal right to claim minimum 100 days of employment. So this, but though this you can relate to some extent this with MG Narega, because this is the urban self-employment or your skilled wage employment program. So it aims to reduce poverty vulnerability by providing the employment opportunities, so resulting in the appreciable improvement in their livelihoods on a sustainable basis through building strong grassroots levels. So also it aims to provide the shelter equipped with essential services to the urban homeless in a phased manner. So basically you can see that basically the projects that will be taken, they will be housing projects in which employment will also be generated, and then shelters will also be built, and they will be getting this essential services through it. So to address the livelihood concern of urban street vendors by facilitating with suitable space, institutional credit, social security and skills to the urban street vendor for accessing emerging market opportunities. So the scheme has two components, one for urban India and the other for rural India. So Deen Dayal Antodaya Yojana and then Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. So they both these are implemented by different bodies. That is Deen Dayal Antodaya Yojana is implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and then your urban poverty alleviation, and then your this rural component, that is Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana, is implemented by Ministry of Rural Development. And next come here, consider the following statements about e-cigarettes. First, it contains very few amount of nicotine compared to the traditional tobacco based cigarettes. Second, it is legal in India to sell e-cigarettes. So which of the above statements is correct? So friends, here there has been a mistake. So the answer must be A. So it is not legal to sell e-cigarettes in India, rather it is banned. So electronic cigarette is a battery powered vaporizer that mimics tobacco smoking. So nicotine juice is there in various flavors, and the nicotine level is there, and it is e-cigarette is composed of five ingredients, that is vegetable glycerin, a material used in all types of food and personal care products like toothpaste, and then propylene glycol, a solvent most commonly used in fog machines, and the propylene glycol is in the ingredient that produces thicker clouds of vapor. And proponents of e-cigarettes argue that the practice is healthier than traditional, because users are only inhaling water vapor and nicotine. So why it is hard to regulate it? E-cigarettes contain nicotine and not tobacco, so they do not fall within the ambit of cigarettes and other tobacco products Act 2003. So please note it. So this e-cigarettes, they are not falling under this category. So which mandates stringent health warnings on the packaging and advertisements of tobacco products? So the answer must be A and not B. Sorry for the mistake. And let's move on to the next question. Consider the following statements related to compensatory forestation fund management and planning authority. First, there is a mandatory social audit for every project implemented under the Act. Second, the state fund created under the Act receives 90% of the fund and the remaining goes to the center. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So the answer is B, that is second only. So this state fund is created under the Act, and it receives 90% of the fund, and remaining fund goes to the center. So what is basically this about this authority and act? Basically this act provides for the compensatory amount that has to be paid by different corporations for the projects they undertake, in which they undertake deforestation. So if there is a particular project, the deforestation is involved in a particular project, then that project has to do what it has to do. It has basically make provision for compensatory forestation amount, so that fund goes to this proper fund that is created under the Act. So the state receives 90% of the fund and 10% goes to the center. So the solution is B. So basically Supreme Court of India ordered the establishment of this authority in 2001, and in 2006 it was established for the management of afforestation fund. So basically this act is to compensate loss of forest area and to maintain the sustainability of the government of India with a well-defined act. So it establishes National Compensatory Afforestation Fund under the public accounts of India and state compensatory waiver restoration account under the fund under the public account of each state. So fund is it at two levels, that is central level and at the state level. So at the state level there is the 90% of the amount goes to the state level fund and 10% of the amount goes to the national level fund. So they are under their respective public accounts. So this receives payment, this fund receives payment for compensatory afforestation, net present value of forest and other project specific payments. And national fund receive 10% of these funds and state fund receive 90%. So according to the act, a company diverting forest land must provide the alternative land to take up compensatory afforestation. So if there is a diversion of forest land, then there must be alternative land that must be provided for compensatory afforestation, and if our afforestation company should pay to plant new trees in the alternative land provided to the state. So please note that not just the component of money is there, but also component of land is there. So if afforestation has to be carried out, then land has to be provided by the corporation, and then amount for the planting of trees must be provided by the corporation. Which of the now let's come to the next question. Next is, which of the following is considered the liability of RBI? Is there considered the liability of RBI? First, currency in circulation. Second, CRR deposits of the bank. Third, gold with the RBI. So we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. So friends, let me tell you that answer 1 and 2 is correct. Liabilities of RBI is basically currency in circulation, deposit of states and central governments, and your CRR deposits of the banks, and contingency fund, that is meet unexpected and unforced emergencies, and currency and gold revaluation account. So to meet the currency and exchange related risks. So you might be confused with why this third is not included. So friends, it doesn't maintain gold as such, but it maintains the amount maintains the amount to the tune of value of the gold. So gold is not responsible for gold, it is responsible for basically the amount. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to geographical indication. First, geographical indication is designed to agricultural goods, products and handicrafts only. Second, the GI tag is valid for the period of 10 years only. So which of the above statements is correct, friends? B statement is correct, that it is valid for 10 years only. Why first statement is not correct? It is not just assigned to agricultural goods, products and handicrafts, but rather it is also given to particular regions, for example, natural heritage. So if there is some unique feature, then that can also get natural feature which is unique, then that can also get the tag of GI. That can also get the GI tag. So it remains valid for the period of 10 years only. So what is it? Basically, it is given for goods that are defined as the aspect of industrial property which refer to a country or to a place situated therein as being the country or place of origin of that product. So it typically name conveys assurance of unique quality and identity of reputation, and then distinctiveness attributable to its geographical origin, and then allows the for the product to command a premium price, and when sold it allocates the product as a public property and thereby unauthorized use by any company. It confers the legal protection to the product. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, project 75i is in the news related to A. Space exploration project, B. defense project, C. commemoration of 75th anniversary of independence movement, D. none of the above. So the answer is B, that is defense project. So it is basically related to the Navy. So under project 75i, India will be purchasing 6 next generation diesel submarines basically from France. So with air independent propulsion system. So please note this point, this is very important. So it basically aims to purchase 6 next generation diesel submarines that have air independent propulsion system. So these diesel electric submarines have to surface every few days to get oxygen to recharge their batteries. So this problem has to be to do away with this problem. This air independent propulsion system, what it will do, it can stay submerged for a much longer period. So as is clear from its name, air independent. So its dependence upon the air, that is the oxygen, and the oxygen therein will be less. So it will remain below the subsurface for quite a long period, and this will obviously enhance steel capability. So for that 75, I will probably have both have vertical launch BrahMos for the sea and land targets and tube launch torpedoes for anti-submarine warfare. Next is Shagun portal is in news, is related to A. student loan portal, B. open learning portal, D. Online portal for school education. So the answer is student loan portal. So this online portal for school education. So Shagun is basically for the capability building of the teachers. So HRD ministry has started this. It has launched world's largest integrated online junction for school education, that is Shagun. So it is an overarching initiative to improve school education system by creating a junction for all online portal and websites relating to various activities of Department of School Education and Literacy. The word Shagun is coined from two different words, that is Shala, that means schools, and Gunvatta, meaning quality. So please note it. The project is of HRD ministry. So next is Special Protection Group is under the administration control of A. Ministry of Home Affairs, B. Cabinet Secretariat of India, C. Ministry of Defense, D. None of the above. So the answer is Cabinet Secretariat of India. So what is this Special Protection Group? It is basically friends security that is provided to VIPs, very very important persons in India. So basically in 1985, following the recommendations that were set up by the Ministry of Home Affairs, a special unit was created for this purpose, and it was placed under the Cabinet Secretariat. So this was initially called Special Protection Group Unit and was renamed as Special Protection Group in April 1985. So the Parliament subsequently passed the Special Protection Group Act 1988, which to provide for the constitutional regulation of an armed force of the Union for providing proximate security to the Prime Minister of India and for matters connected therewith. So basically it aims to provide security to the Prime Minister. So it is directly under the Cabinet Secretariat. So it defined proximate security as protection provided from close quarters during journey by road, rail, aircraft, watercraft, or on foot, or any other means of transport, to include the places of function, engagements, residence, or halt. So coverage is basically extended apart from the Prime Minister to former Prime Ministers of India and members of their immediate families through an amendment in the Act in the aftermath of the assassination of Rajiv Gandhi in May 1991. So categories of security, basically besides SPG, VIPs in India are protected by other security forces as well. So level of security cover is determined by the threat perception around the individual. So highest level of security cover is Z+ security, followed by Z, Y, X categories. So the higher level of cover, the larger the number of personnel protecting the individual. So roughly 24 to 36 personnel with automatic weapons are deployed for Z+ category protectives, and 16 to 20 personnel guard Z category protectives. So the elite black cat commandos of the NSG are deployed to protect the VIPs for whom the threat perception is the highest. So this is all about, friends, today's discussion of MCQs. So if you like these MCQs, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So lastly, friends, if you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can mail us at tyes21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our contact number, that is 8968920720. So you will be getting the PDFs if in case you contact us. So we have kept a minimum subscription fee for it, that is 99 rupees per month, basically for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation, so that we can also remain motivated to help you people. So if in case you are interested to join, then you can contact us, and the link of the subscription will also be given in the description box. So if in case you are interested to join, then do ensure that you check the description box and check the link there. And also lastly, you can join our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen and will also be provided in the description box. And through this Telegram channel, you can remain in touch with us relating to our various updates that we do on our YouTube channel, or for that matter on Telegram. So this is all about, friends, today's video. Do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day ahead.